He's called Blitzy because my mum found him after a blitz in the war when she was about three. In the East End, she jumped out of her pushchair apparently, and there he was amongst all the rubble. Every time we returned to London to visit grandparents, this teddy was a very special teddy that never came to the countryside. He had to stay in London, and I was allowed to take him outside because I can remember feeling very claustrophobic in a flat, and I used to play in the garden out there, and he was allowed to come outside, and I used to always promise him that he'd come and live in the countryside one day. And he does. He's very decaying now, but I did promise him he'd come to the countryside. He's actually been to India with me when I went travelling and did some charity work out there. I put him in the bottom of my rucksack, so he's well travelled. But it was quite a strong thing that I wanted him to live in the countryside with me, because to me that was a so much better place to be than this horrible, dirty, noisy, smelly East End. He's obviously handmade, isn't he? And over the years I've obviously tied him up with bits of but he was never damaged like this, but you know, you can imagine a 6-year-old, 7-year-old trying to, a bit of cotton, obviously. I remember doing that, trying to stitch him up. So that's my memory.